Well, hello again. It is not so early morning in Iceland. You'd think it was kind of early, but the sunrises here are really late. Today it's about 9:33, I think, is the sunrise, but it's been absolutely gorgeous all morning, pretty much since 7:30 this morning. We had a clear night, which is our first in a while, so this is pretty exciting. And you can see why. This is a pretty insane view. So I do actually have a theme for this vlog, but I just want to say, over there, it's Thomas Heaton. Yeah, so that's Peter Iverson gave me a heads up that he would be here, maybe? And so I was already here, so I've been keeping my eye out for an orange jacket. And yeah, he's over there shooting something. Don't know if I can be weird and go say hi. We'll see. But I'm gonna try to concentrate on what's going on here, because the colors here are just absolutely insane. We had it clear out quite a bit last night. It was cloudy last few days and rainy, really not nice. This morning, we've got these beautiful, beautiful, beautiful sunrise colors over here, but what's really amazing is the colors in the grass, of course the black sand, but then also this little jetty here in the front. So one of the tricks when shooting Vestrahorn, or it's, as it's called, Stock's Nest, is trying to find a foreground for your image. Of course, you've got this incredible background here, the snow-covered mountain, although it's a little bit light on snow, and you've got the incredible mountain range over there. The trick is finding a foreground, and so traditionally people will go for the gold grass and dunes and stuff, but that's not quite enough. So as we talked about in a previous vlog, not only do you need subjects and a good composition, you need something to tie them together, that is, shapes. So what I do is I try to look for subjects first. I look for my foreground, midground, background, but that's not quite enough. I then look for shapes to connect them together, and so that's going to be elements. Very often in my photography, it ends up being jetties, but you can use just about anything as a shape. I love looking for certain kinds of curves, M curves, S curves. So here what I'm doing is I'm using the jetty as a curve that ties together the grass in the foreground with the midground dunes, and then with the mountains in the background. Without that shape to connect them, they'd be kind of separated. You wouldn't naturally have the eye wandering and roving through the image. But in this case, we're using it to connect all those elements together. But the theme of this vlog is actually a little bit different from that in just incredible beauty, and that is, should you actually be shooting without a polarizing filter? And so this is something that I've run into in my trip earlier this year. When I went to Oregon, I shot on an ultra-wide angle for the first time. Go check out the link in the description to go see the details on that. Some of the lessons that I learned from shooting it. One of the big things I learned is generally with a ultra-wide angle, you rarely want to shoot with a polarizer turned such that it is making any effect on the clouds or the water in the foreground. So I generally take it off a lot of the times. Now, I like to leave it on there as protection, but I have to be really careful about the orientation, because otherwise what it'll do is it'll darken just part of the sky and the rest will still be light, which means I'm gonna have a post-production mess. So I'm actually shooting this whole thing without a polarizing filter. Now, what you might think is, wow, we've got water here in the foreground, maybe we should be putting on a polarizing filter to cut down the reflections. But actually, and I'll show you a quick before and after, without the polarizing filter on, you see the really nice whites on the water. And we talked about that as being a source of neutral tones in an image. Neutral tones are grayscale colors that help root the image's color palette, and they tell you, hey, this is what neutral should look like. Without them, the viewer doesn't really have a good idea of what the white balance of the image is. And so if I turn the polarizing filter to hide those reflections, we actually won't have those whites anymore, which means we lose our neutral tones. We also lose our shape, because then it'll just be pretty much black, which, so then we won't be able to see the water in the first place. So when shooting water, if I make it an important part of my composition, very often I don't use the polarizing filter, because the polarizing filter will cut away your source of neutral tones and something to highlight and connect the different elements in the region together. Sorry if the camera is shaking. I am freezing out here. It is probably around 30, but because we're near the water, it's a very cold chill, which makes it feel a lot worse than it probably is. Oh man, so much beauty. So I would recommend don't shoot with polarizing filter if you want to use water as one of your connecting elements. And here the water is pretty still. I shot here two times before now. I shot yesterday right after sunset. It was really cloudy, so you couldn't really see anything, but the water was very still. I also came and shot astrophotography last night around 10 o'clock, because it gets dark here so early. It gets dark around 4:30 or 5 o'clock, and the pools were already very still, and so that made a great composition. And because it was so still, you really didn't need to cut out any reflections in the water. In fact, those reflections are what make this shot so beautiful and give you something to connect it together. All right, well, I'm going to finish up a few more images. I'm going to see if I can not so subtly stop Thomas Heaton. So, I'll catch up with you later.